mnakaa serikali sasa, mnakaa serikali kabisa. So mine is first of all to really really congratulate you, and of course to really appreciate the cabinet secretary and the principal secretary for allowing us also to come and interact with you to be part of this function. As we have been informed that you've been going through an induction program for the last 5 days, we are very, very happy because we know that you are the best that the government could get in terms of ACCs. When we put out the advert, we got over 50,000 applications. We shortlisted, I think, about 3,000, Muriki. And you happened to be those who succeeded. You are 659. Can you just give yourself a round of applause? So according to us, and how we assessed you when we were interviewing you, you really did very well. So, and unless you prove us otherwise, we told your bosses and your team here that we have given you the right people for the job. So what we're expecting from you is that you be good ambassadors of the government, you be good ambassadors of the commission, because remember that the Public Service Commission is still the employer.
Total shortfall of establishment when we sat with Public Service Commission was actually 859. And we said, through your guidance, go and negotiate there, so that at the bottom, we get 859, meaning that the number of bodies in the ministry have filled the establishment. Then we push the ones who are up to fill the establishment. Today, and I want to most sincerely thank Public Service Commission for the support. They have opened up, promoted the ones who are up, so that all the establishment from Job Group T all the way are filled by officers who are in the ministry, and the gaps that are left at the bottom and filled by the 859 of these people. We want to sincerely thank you, our Public Service Commission, for making that possible. You may not know what you have done to this country, but what you have done to this country means, because the collapse of law and order in this country that we were witnessing, Waziri, a few years ago, was because of the historical problem of not filling these positions. And as a consequence, we had a lot of sublocations not manned, a lot of locations, all the way the administrative units not manned. And there was no way you are going to keep law and order when you don't have a commander. And I think through this intervention, now we can comfortably say we only have a few sublocations that are not filled, not because we don't have an establishment, but because some of them are also very difficult to fill, like, you know, this time. You keep trying to fill, but they keep refusing to be filled. The others are full. And the consequence...
When we were fighting digital migration, we went all the way to the Supreme Court. And now look where we are today. If we had not freed all that spectrum and so on, I don't know how we'd be operating today. In the era of COVID and so on, when we have to do these virtual meetings and stuff like that, I don't know how we'd be operating today. Look at how many TV stations we have in the country, how many radio stations we have in the country, and how we're able to communicate. If we had not migrated at that time, I don't know what we would be doing today. Yet, you know, the High Court ruled against us. The Court of Appeal ruled against us. We had to go to the Court of to the Supreme Court to get judgment that enabled us to migrate from analog to digital broadcasting. And on the Huduma card and the Huduma number, I want to assure you, I am prepared, and my colleagues in government, we are prepared to go all the way. We have no problem even ending up in the Supreme Court on this matter. Because it's very simple, and all of you understand this, and if you may allow me to take a second on this, it's unthinkable that anybody can think otherwise in this day and age. Because if we have data on your ID with the National Registration Bureau, we have data on your birth certificate, we have data on your PIN at KRA, we have data on your driver's license at the NTSA. What we are doing is bringing all that data together so that you are one person, so that you use one card and one number to access services. What is illegal about that? I don't know where some people live. Just go to some countries in the Middle East. The president of Estonia was here the other day. And it's amazing what she told us and what they're able to achieve in terms of technology. We cannot be the only country where you need a handbag to carry your cards. So that, you know, when you get to the petrol station, you remove your bank card. When you go to hospital, you remove another card. When you get to the airport, you remove another document. When you're going to check NHIF, you remove another card. The people who are opposed to this are the cartels who have made a living out of stealing public funds by coming up with all manner of conflicting systems. So they will supply a different software and different system at NTSA and insist that they're providing a digital license. Then they will go to KRA and look for another system. And they've been making money like this. This theft of public resources. And this is really what is being protected. So we will go to the Court of Appeal because we are law-abiding. We will go to the Court of Appeal on this matter. And again, just like digital migration, we're here again in the country where we're arguing about ourselves and arguing against each other or something that should be driven by common sense. But that's how everyone lives. You just get one card, one single source of truth. Instead of you being so many people, you know, at NHIF, you are one person. At the National Registration Bureau, you are another person. At the Registrar of Births and Deaths, you are another person. You know, when you go to the Attorney General to check your marriage records, you are again another person. You know, and so on and so forth. And we are getting all these data sets and integrating them so that we give you one card. And when you get that card being read by a machine, they can get all the other information they need and services given to you in minutes. We want to go to a place where you can even go without one card. When you get to the petrol station, you can actually fuel using it because it can access your bank account and get the 2,000 shillings that you have used to pay for fuel and walk away. That's where technology is going. We cannot be the only country on earth where you need to buy a handbag to carry your cards around. So we will go to the Court of Appeal on the matter because we believe at some point in the chain of seeking to explain ourselves, someone will be reasonable enough and listen to us and see that what we are doing is good for our country and good for the way we are going to go forward.